to ADvTECH, a stock that closed about 2.5% weaker today. This after they concluded agreements for the acquisition of the Maravest Group. Leslie Massdorp, the CEO of ADvTECH, joins us on the line for more. Leslie, thank you for making the time to join us. Maybe let's just get you just giving us the rationale behind that acquisition right now. Many have said that perhaps ADvTECH has been a bit late to the game, and Caro and others have been off the starting blocks far sooner.
Good evening, Nozipo. Thanks very much for having me. Just to set out the basic rationale for this transaction, I mean, as you might recall, about 2 months ago, we announced also a significant acquisition, in fact, our biggest acquisition thus far, when we announced the acquisition of the Centurus College Group. So this acquisition of the Maravest Group kind of further, I think, I would say, entrenched our leadership role in sort of premium education space, school space in South Africa. So I'd say that what's interesting about the Maravest Group for us is that it combines both the sort of premium end schools, because they own three schools that sort of logically fit into the core competency of ADvTECH, and I'm referring to Maragon Reimsig, Maragon Abianto, which is opening in January, as well as the Charterhouse School. But in addition, they also own a couple of schools, what we would target, part of our new target market, in the sort of lower fee segment. That is a sort of high growth area which you've just made reference to. I don't think in any way we relate to the game at all. I mean, over the last 6 years, we've invested just over R1 billion rand in sort of new schools, expanding our existing capacity. This year alone, if you add now Centurus Group that I just mentioned, as well as the Maragon acquisition, we've made north of 1.4 billion rand we spent on our growth strategy. So I don't think we late in the game at all, in the sense that this market is expanding. I think there will be new players entering this market, and in time to come, I also see us expanding outside of South Africa. So we don't take just a domestic view on with respect to our expansion strategy. We very much look at the rest of sub-Saharan Africa as our target market as well.
Leslie, just below the sub-Saharan level, in other words, in South Africa, are you going to be in the future an acquirer or a developer? I mean, are there any other things to acquire, for example?
Yeah, look, I'd say that we combined the two lenses. Firstly, we announced a couple of months ago our 3 billion rand program over the next decade. So over the next 10 years, we're building just under 20 schools, and that is just part of our organic sort of growth, if you like, so expanding into our existing school brands. But we will also, so the two acquisitions I just mentioned, the Centurus Group as well as the one that we just concluded today, these two fall outside of that 3 billion rand program. So the bulk of our focus is actually on the sort of organic growth. And then, as I said, while South Africa, at the moment we are a South African company, our footprint is only in the sort of main urban centers here. We see significant growth potential outside of the Gauteng region, which is where all of these new acquisitions I've mentioned now, Centurus, as well as the Maravest Group, are sort of Gauteng-based. We see significant opportunities in the rest of the country and also in neighboring states in time to come.
Leslie, it's Mark here in the studio, Joburg. You're very bullish on the outlook for private education, effectively. Parents watching this, many of whom are very hard-pressed to having to pay their school fees out of after-tax income. Do you have a sense of the quantum of the market out there, Leslie, and the degree to which it's actually affordable for people?
Look, I'd say that there's a wide range, Mark, when you look at private education, right? So you have a couple of schools that sort of occupy this top of the pyramid. These are sort of exclusive elite private schools, right? And, you know, very few parents can afford to send their kids to those type of schools. And yeah, I'm referring to the kind of St. Andrews's, the Michael House's, Hilton's, et cetera, right? Then you'll have a range of schools, sort of what we're just calling the sort of premium end, right? These are schools where, you know, obviously those who can afford to pay 80 to 90,000 rand a year, there is a specific market segment in South Africa who can afford that, and there's clearly a continuous demand for that particular segment. But the massive growth market is below that. The massive growth is in, I would say, in the area between 24,000 rand, as low as that, between 24,000 and 36,000. There's a massive market there of people who are disgruntled for a number of reasons for the public sector, and who parents who want a quality education and who look for private offerings. I should add, though, that there are also private schools now offering private quality education for as low as 1,000 to 1,500 rand per month. There's a couple of schools that opened last year. There's a few more that I'm aware of that will open in 2015. So the range is quite wide in terms of the offering.
Leslie, thank you so much for making the time to join us. That's the CEO of ADvTECH.